So, continuing on from last week's video. The more we look at David Sidwick, the more we realize what a gargantuan piece of anal butter this prick is. Here's a video from last year that David has done with Joy Allen, a fellow PCC commissioner. We have only made one edit, and that's removing a reference to a death of a friend's small child made by David that has nothing to do with our beef with him. Apart from that, straight from the horse face's mouth. David, over to you.
And so we're very clear. There's four things that we need. We need tough enforcement. We have a resolute government. We have PCCs. We're going to be tough on drugs and the violence around drugs.
So, David's first point. Tougher enforcement against hard drugs that do direct damage to people's health, plus lessening the impact on the region's economic budget. So will you agree that decriminalising cannabis, something that is proven to be non-addictive, a drug you cannot overdose on, and has the potential to provide medical and fiscal benefits to the UK, would add some benefit to your point?
But we need effective rehabilitation. We've just had Dame Carol Black's wonderful review, and that clearly outlines what we need.
So, point two. Better rehabilitation. Okay, but to rehabilitate, then there has to be an initial addiction or medical impact affecting the person as a direct consequence of using whatever the drug is in question. It looks like you need reminding again of addiction versus dependency. Cannabis is proven to be non-addictive and provides a plethora of medical benefits. Point three, please.
We can't just enforce our way out of this situation. We have to help those who are already addicted to drugs, to alcohol, to gambling. But we've got to go further. There's two other things. We need impactful education. We need to talk to them in terms that make sense. We need to tell them the stories. The stories of the people who have psychosis and testicular cancer from cannabis.
Jesus, David, what was that? So that means all cannabis users, including women, are walking around getting testicular cancer. You forgot to mention that the doctors who conducted the study said that this was only applicable to non-seminoma cancer types. So, that's applicable to only 50% of testicular cancer sufferers. Also, you forgot to mention that the researchers admitted that the evidence they did find was low strength, and it was based on smoking cannabis only. The researchers did not study the effects of using any other type of marijuana, such as edibles. And as we know, smoking anything is bad for you, in many ways. I mean, David, look at all those testicles rolling around the streets of Amsterdam. Everyone tripping over them as they negotiate the price for a triple anal fingering in the red light district. That was your third point. What's next?
The two lads in their 20s who don't have bladders because of their addiction to ketamine.
What the fuck?
Okay, this is getting silly now, David. Just read this study, look at the misdiagnosis comment and have a word. Yes, ketamine abuse is dangerous and does lead to an increased chance in urinary infections. But to take two isolated instances to sensationalize your pathetic argument. Shame on you. So, point four, please.
We've got to talk in those terms.
Absolutely. We're two new PCCs, two different political parties, but we've come together with a passion.
A passion for bullshit, obviously.
To reduce addictions and substance misuse.
Absolutely. We're very clear. It's about enforcing the now, but fixing the future.
David, that's only three things. Rehabilitation. Enforcement. Education.
And so we're very clear. There's four things that we need.
Is counting past three a little too tough for you, Dave? So, to add to the 15 questions you have to answer from last week, here's another two for you. One, can you count past the number three? And two, when will you start using facts instead of sensationalizing the narrative to suit your skewed argument? And we'll leave the final word to Jeff.
That is one big pile of shit.
Oh, David.